we're walking on not joists. It's a floor.
It's a subfloor.
Are you floored? We're floored. You're welcome.
It hurts so bad. It doesn't even hurt good. All right. So you were looking at our subfloor. We just finished it this evening. And
Just moments ago.
And yeah, it's pretty cool. We can actually walk around in our trailer now. And gotta tell ya,
I'm in the closet. This is where our closet's gonna be. That's not, never mind.
I've checked, he's straight. So yeah, bathroom, closet, kitchen, living room, front door down there. We're trying to get into the habit of actually calling our tiny house by the ship directions. We've actually noticed it's gotten really confusing with left, right, front, back.
Yeah, because the hitch is the front, but also the door is the front, or the back, because it's the... So
this is the bow.
Starboard. Port. Stern.
It's a land ship.
And I guess the lofts would be topside?
Sure. Crow's nest.
That would be the roof, I think.
Alright, no, that's fair. Anyway, so the subfloor was a lot of work. Way more than we anticipated.
Way more.
Anyone who tells you that screwing into metal is, like, not that big of a deal, don't listen to them. It's a ton of work.
Did anybody say that to you?
Yeah, the people who sold us the trailer.
Oh.
Yeah. Like, it's not that big of a deal. I don't know
It's straightforward, but what we ended up doing was getting some self-tapping screws for drilling wood into metal, steel.
Mm-hmm.
And after, like, just trying to drill those straight in with a drill, which was very exhausting, we ended up getting, using the cobalt drill tips that we've used in another video, which I can link here. Not cobalt the company, but cobalt, I just want some cobbler.
So good.
Milwaukee drill bits that are made of cobalt are by far some of the best drill bits I've ever worked with.
Yeah.
And I would highly recommend them for pre-drilling the holes for the for doing any kind of work like this through wood, through metal. Then you can go back with the self-tapping screws and just...
Yeah.
Just so much easier and faster.
Yeah.
So, and we were able to tag team that. I wasn't just doing all the work, and she was staring at me, cheering me on, which was, you know, I appreciated, but this was more efficient.
I was really shy to use the drills and the drivers, and once I got the hang of it, it was pretty straightforward. You just gotta be really patient. I think the other thing that another lesson to take away on this is I think advantech as a product is a good product. I'm not sure it's the easiest thing to work with on this trailer where you have metal that you have to screw into and you have to be really, really, really precise.
Mm.
And which I think would have worked better, but we chose to use advantech going the opposite way that it's supposed to. So it's supposed to run lengthwise.
It's supposed to go perpendicular to the joist, specifically.
Yeah.
So it can work like this, but you're not going to get that secure tongue and groove connection. You kind of have to get it close and kind of in the groove, but not super in there, because otherwise you're not going to line up with the joist all the way through. And that's just...
There was so much to line up using advantech because it was designed to be pretty precise and to line up, and not using it the way that it needed to go.
Which probably would have worked just fine. We just decided to do it this way. So.
And on top of, we chose to widen our trailer by 2 inches. Yeah. So that
98 inches.
Yeah, so that allowed that. We couldn't just plop one piece of advantech across 8 feet and call it a day. We actually had to trim it, line it up, line up the tongue and groove with the joist. I mean, there's just so much to calculate and to make sure it all fit together. And in the end, I feel like we did a pretty damn good job. It's not like spot on, but I'm learning nothing spot on in construction.
But we're going to try.
Yeah. But, and also using this product, going the way that it's not supposed to, they have these nifty little markers where you drill in 16 on center, 24 inch on center, whatever your build is. And we couldn't use those because we chose to use it in a different direction. So we actually had to mark where we drilled in. And what we ended up doing, because advantech suggested this, was 6 inches apart on the exterior.
On the perimeter of each board.
There you go. On the perimeter of each board. We did 8 inches on the side here because the joists were 16 apart. And we had to, so we just drilled one in between them. And then a foot going across the joists in the middle is what we did. Mm-hmm. And yeah, so not only did we use advantech the wrong way, but we also, we talked about in previous videos, we didn't use the suggested floor insulation. Mm. So this subfloor was...
It was a pain.
It was.
Learn from our mistakes. That said, now that it's finished, it feels good. It feels like a very, very solid floor.
This floor is going nowhere.
Nowhere. Where are you going? Nowhere.
That's right. Yeah.
Yeah. Boondock Saints. Anyway, you'll see a perimeter of blue all the way around the outside of it. And what that is an idea we got from Tiny Nest. Props to those guys. They're pretty awesome. Check them out.
Yeah.
We'll link to those videos. But because one piece wouldn't go all the way across, one idea we got from them in their trailer subfloor building video was to cut it so it just fits the wall on the outside of it. And so there's that line all the way across is just big enough for a 2x4 wall foundation to go right there. On top of the vapor barrier and then sill seal. So it'd be wall, moisture barrier, sill seal, trailer.
Yeah.
From top to bottom.
Which doing that allowed us to use a lot less material of the advantech, but I gotta be honest with you folks, if we're gonna do it all over again, I might just get some regular OSB board, which would have been way more forgiving, because we hardly ended up using any of the advantages that advantech has to offer as a product. Like, the tongue and groove didn't end up fitting, we had to make our own little marks. The one thing I can be like, yay, is that it's pretty water resistant.
Yeah.
So, that's cool.
So, essentially, we got the durability of advantech.
Yeah.
And not much else.
Yeah.
But that's okay. We're okay with durability. Like, we'll put up with the short-term headaches for the long-term gain. That's fine.
Yeah.
As long as we only have to deal with the short-term headaches for a short time.
Yeah. But if you got, like, some marine-grade plywood, pretty sure that would have...
Probably would have worked fine.
Yeah. So, lesson learned. So unless you plan on laying advantech the correct way, you'll have to use a lot more material that way. But I think that's it. I think that's all the advice we have. What we learned. We're super proud of our floor.
Where are they? What? And we bought 300 self-tapping screws, and we have 2 left. We didn't use 300 or 298. We probably used somewhere in the neighborhood of 250, 275 on all this. So yeah, it's not going anywhere. But we have 2 left. I was really worried we were going to run out.
And we didn't.
But we had Mama Screw, Papa Screw right here.
Yes.
Signature. So cheers, love.
Cheers.
Ting.
Beep.
Hold on, let's get a close-up of that.
Okay.
Come on. Come here. Ting. This is awful. What is this? And now we're going to dance on our floor now, so you can watch. Come on,
no, we're gonna go home for barbecue.
I'm gonna go home for barbecue.
Yeah.
Zephyr Tiny House.
Subscribe.
If you want. Do it.
Barbecue.
Okay.